So, as tech recently, I met someone in the house. They had this case, a 52-year-old lady, right? She was a hypertensive, uncontrolled diabetes, right? And then she had, as expected, bleed, right? Hospital leke gaye, wahan craniotomy hui, sab kuch hua. And then because they didn't know ki koi rehab center hai, they actually went home. Ab 3 months ho gaye, tracheostomy nikal gayi hai, bed sore hai, right? And she's still not independent. So, aise case mein kya karna chahiye?
First of all, in this patient, obviously rehabilitation is required. After removal of tracheostomy, is she able to speak now?
Nahin, abhi bhi nahi, she is not able to understand, right? Or baki I'll tell them to come to your OPD. But basically, agar main tumko batana ho ki kya kya kar sakte hain, tum kya kya kar sakte hain case mein? How much recovery can we give?
And especially any type of stroke that happens, first 6 months is considered a golden period, but the maximum recovery can happen. It is not a definite period, recovery continues, but mostly after 6 months it plateaus. Mm-hmm. The pace of recovery slows down.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's been just 3 months, then patient has a chance to make there some recovery. So she should be sent to a proper rehabilitation center where all the things that she require is available to her. Like as you mentioned that she is not able to speak. So it is in medical terminology, we call it aphasia. जैसे आपने पता कि लेफ्ट साइड का स्ट्रोक हुआ है सो लेफ्ट साइड इज अ पार्ट ऑफ ब्रेन जहाँ पे स्पीच सेंटर्स आए सो जो डोमिनेंट पार्ट ऑफ ब्रेन होता है जैसे हम मोस्टली राइट हैंड से लिखते हैं तो लेफ्ट साइड का जो ब्रेन होता है वो डोमिनेंट होता है सो इन द डोमिनेंट पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन व्हेन एवर स्ट्रोक हैपेंस देयर कैन हैव अफेजिया खाने में दिक्कत हो सकती है डिस्फेजिया भी हो सकता है सो इन दिस काइंड ऑफ पेशेंट स्पीच एंड सोलो थेरेपी बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट
Right.
And there are certain sets of exercises that speech therapy does, which can help. There are certain type of medications which I can prescribe, which can help with improving the aphasia.
Mm-hmm.
And then coming back to the oral rehabilitation plan, she must be requiring physical therapy and occupational therapy. So she is in bedbound condition. She is not independent.
Mm-hmm.
And that bedbound condition itself causes a lot of problems.
Mm-hmm.
It's a bed sore. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
isliye these are called secondary complications of stroke.
Mm-hmm.
Stroke aane se to ek hua hai, dikkat hui hai, khane mein dikkat hui hai, bolne mein dikkat hui hai, paralysis ho gaya hai. But yadi hum uski proper treatment nahi lete, to secondary complications hote hain. जो और दिक्कत करते हैं जैसे बेड सोर हो गया धीरे धीरे बिकॉज ऑफ द लैक ऑफ मोबिलिटी मसल मास रिड्यूस हो जाता है बोन पड़े पड़े वीक हो जाते हैं ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस हो जाता है सो ऑल दिस लीड टू अ सेकेंडरी कॉम्प्लिकेशन इवन लेग में भी कई पेशेंट में डीबीटी हो जाता है क्योंकि लेग फिक्स इमोबिलाइज नहीं हो रहा है सो फॉर टू रिड्यूस ऑल दिस सेकेंडरी कॉम्प्लिकेशन एंड प्रमोट द रिकवरी पेशेंट रिक्वायर्स इंटेंसिव रिहैबिलिटेशन थेरेपी